Okay, let me continue with the features of Unix operating system. As I was discussing that, using the ls-l command, we can display all the 7 attributes of all the files present in the present working directory. So here, ls-l command is providing total 72, means total 72 files are present in the current working directory. Now each file is displayed with name in the last column and 7 attributes, 6 more attributes are there. So see, you can see that for the file name chapter 01, it is --rw --r --r-. It means first is dash, means it is a regular file. So chapter 01 file is a regular file, means it is a text file. Next one, chapter 2, department.first, ne.sh, they are also just a regular file, text file. But you can see that help directory and proc here, first point, at first place D stands for directory. Means help dir file and proc file, both are directory file. Next is rw dash, means first 3 letters is for owner of the file, means what are the permissions owner of the file has. The owner who had created the chapter 01 file, they have the permission read write permission on the chapter 01. It doesn't have the execute permission even for the owner of the file. Next 3, that is r dash dash, is for group owner. Means anybody who belongs to a group in which even owner of the file is also a member, they have the permission only for read permission. It doesn't have the write and execute permission. Similarly, others also have the read only permission. Here you can see that for the directory, for chapter file name department.first, it has the for owner, it has the permission read write. For group owner also it has the permission read write, and others also it has the permission read and write. You can see that for the file name help directory, help dir, it is a directory, and it for owner it has all the 3 permissions like read, write and execute permission. Next three is r dash x, means group owner have the permission of read and execute, it doesn't have the permission to write. Next 3, read r dash x, means others also have the permission to read and execute, but it doesn't have the permission to write in the file. So directories, so this is how the next is the Kumar, means Kumar is the owner of this file proc. Next one, Metal. So Kumar belongs to a group called Metal. Next one, file size 512 bytes, means proc size of the file, proc has 512 bytes. Next one is May 9, 1957, that is the last modification time for the file. So last time the file was modified on May 9 at 9:57 and then file. So similarly, all files have their own 7 attributes. File ownership. When you create a file, you become its owner, as I told so many times. And every owner is attached to a group owner. As like in the previous slide, you can see that owner of the file chapter 01 is Kumar, but Kumar also belongs to a group called Metal. So every owner attached to a group. Several users may belong to a single group, but the privileges of the group are set by the owner of the file and not by the group member. So in a group, so many members will be present, but for the group members, what privileges will be given, whether to read, write and execute, or only to read and write, or only to read, or no permission is given. So it depends on the owner of the file, what privileges he wants to give to other members of the file of the group, he can set. Next, when the system administrator creates a user account, he has to assign these parameters to a user. So suppose you are as a user logging to the Unix operating system, then system administrator will set your account. And these are the following ID it will provide you. That is, first one is UID, that is called user ID. Second one is GID, that is called group ID. Here once again we can study in the details about the file permission. Unix follows a three-tiered file protection system that determines a file access right. It displays in the following format. File type, owner, group owner and others. So first three, if RWX is there, so owner has all the permission to read, write and execute. Then group owner, for group owner it has read, write and execute, and others also it can have read, write and execute. For example, suppose we have a file name called chapter 02 and here dash RWX R dash X R dash dash is there. Means first dash is there, means it is a file, it is not a directory. Then next three is there RWX, next R dash X, and next one is R dash dash. Means RWX is for owner or user. Means owner or user have all the three permission, read, write and execute. Next one R dash X, it is for the group owner. So group owner have the permission only read and execute. It doesn't have the permission to write. For others, R dash dash is there, means others have only the permission to read. They cannot write or execute the file. The owner has all three permissions. The file is readable, writable and executable by the owner of the file. So here you can see, for owner, read, write and execute, all the three permissions have. Means owner can read, write and execute the file. The group has a hyphen in the middle slot which indicates the absence of write permission by the group owner of the file. Same thing which I discussed. The third group has the write and execute bits absent. Means other people have only read permission. It cannot write and execute. And this set of permission is applicable to others. So others only can read. They cannot write and execute the file. Okay, we'll stop up till here. In the next video, we will be starting with changing file permission. How we can change the permission of the file.